after 9 months, I just buy my own truck, you know, somebody was selling it and I got it in payments. I'm like 25 trucks, yeah. The business is gonna do around 5,000 a week after everything, you know. It's a business, you know, you don't need to take it personal, you know. If they want to make money, they have families. You want to make money, you have families, you know. Because before it was a little bit harder to have all the maintenance, all the stuff coming, and then to get $1.80, $2 a mile, it's very hard, you know. Right now it's much easier. So my goal is to reach at least 100, you know.
Hey guys, what's up? How much do owner operators make? Is it $10,000 per month, $20,000 or $30,000? How's the industry right now? Is it the right time to get into trucking business right now or to get your authority? What's the current dollar per mile? Is it possible to grow your business from one truck to maybe 10 trucks or 25 trucks? Well, to answer all these queries, I'm going to talk to Cornell from Onyx Logistics. He's been there, done that. He was a driver himself and he grew his business from one truck to 25 trucks in the last 10 years. And his aim is to add another 75 trucks and make it to 100 in the next 2 years. So he's going to answer all these queries. I'm Jerry, founder of Max Truckers and a logistics expert. I work with the carriers and owner operators in US and Canada and help them to grow their business and maximize profits. Please do subscribe to our channel Max Truckers because we come out with a lot of informative video. So, on behalf of Max Truckers, let's welcome Cornell to the channel. Hey, hi Cornell. Thanks for coming on Max Truckers. It's so good to have you here. You know, I still remember 4 years back, I was sitting in that same room with you and, you know, you were teaching me dispatching. So, thanks for coming on Max Truckers. How are you?
Thank you for inviting me, Jerry. How are you?
I'm good. How are you doing? I'm good. So Cornell, last time I met you like 4 years back, you were having 7 trucks and now I remember now you told me you are on 25 trucks. Is it
true?
Yeah,
now I'm like 25 trucks. Yeah. The business is growing. Wow. Everything is getting.
So Conic Logistics is really doing good.
Yeah, it's doing good. Hopefully, we're going to grow this year more. So
awesome.
Everything is good.
And that's the reason exactly that, I thought I need to discuss with you because you know, we talk to a lot of owner operators who are just getting into trucking or who are into trucking, you know, and they would really like to know. And what I want to focus in this particular talk with you is basically how much do owner operators make in the current season, maybe last year, or what should they be targeting, right? Because a lot of people have this question. And that's the major thing. You're starting your own business to make money. Let's be honest.
Exactly. Everyone
wants to make money, right? So how much can they make? So now, before we start off, so just give a brief about your journey, Cornell. Like, when did you start, and you know, how did you get into trucking?
Yeah, I got into trucking in 2010.
Okay.
You know, a friend of mine, he told me, "Hey, go in trucking because you make money. You know, you can make like 2,000 a week, 3,000." Then in the beginning, you know.
Okay.
So I said, "Okay, let me get the driver license." You know.
Okay.
So I got my driver license and I start driving. You know, the truck. After 9 months, I just buy my own truck, you know, somebody was selling it and I got it in payments.
Okay.
So I got my truck and then, you know, I would start thinking how to open my own business because by then I didn't have, you know, I was leased to somebody. Like with AMC number, I was leased there.
Correct.
Let me try to see if I can open my own business, you know.
Okay.
My own authority and stuff.
Okay.
So, from then, you know, I buy a truck and then I buy another one in 2011 and I put a driver and in 2012 I open my company, you know.
Okay. So in 2 years you started your own company.
Yeah, in 2 years I opened my own company and I got 2 trucks, you know, in 2 years. So yeah.
Okay.
And then
go on.
Yeah, and then in 2013, you know, I have my own AMC number and everything, you know. Because in 2012, I opened the company, but I was still running on somebody AMC, you know.
Okay.
But in 2013, I opened my own AMC. And from then, I just separated, you know.
Oh,
so that was the beginning, you know, kind of summary, the beginning.
So were you still driving that time? And in 2013, were you driving?
I still drive from 2010. I drive up to 2014 because I was dispatching and driving, you know, because I have a truck. And by 2014, I got another one. So I have like 3 trucks. Me one driving and 2 more dispatching on the road, you know.
Okay.
So it was it was a little bit hard, you know, hard time in the beginning, you know. In the first couple of years, it's very hard, you know, to when you open the business and.
Correct.
So, but yeah, that's how I started pretty much, you know, in the beginning. That was the beginning. So
what are your future goals from 25 to now? Where do you want to reach?
My goal is to reach at least 100, you know.
That's
yeah, you're getting 100 awesome. And then you're thinking, yeah, you're thinking what's going to happen then, you know. So yeah, it's a goal for now.
All the best wishes. You know, I personally want you to become not 100, 500 trucks, man. The biggest logistics company in US. Awesome. So now let's look. Let's say I am an owner operator who's just the way you got your authority in 2013, right? I just got my MC and my DOT in place. I have an equipment. So what do you think, you know, owner operators should be making? Let's say if I have a dry van reefer or a flatbed, right? A single equipment in a month, what should be the revenue that I should be targeting or should be making to, you know, save some money?
So from couple years now, like 2 years, is the rates are changing, you know, the owner operator, they're making more money than before.
Okay.
Before, like a regular owner was doing between 3,000 and 5,000 a week.
Okay.
You know, after all the expenses, you know.
Okay.
So was making like 12-15 a month, let's say. Okay. Owner operator. Right now the rates, they got a little bit more consistent, you know. Okay. A little bit high, but they're more up. I don't know, they change maybe because of the situation, you know. Okay. Whatever happened with Corona or something, but the rates, they got up. So right now an owner is gonna do around 5,000 a week after everything, you know. So the rates
after
are
everything.
Up, you know? After everything, yeah.
Okay.
After everything, yeah. So because they pay better, you know, they pay better, or they're consistent, you know.
Yeah.
You're going with $2 or $3 somewhere, you're coming back with $2, you know, it's not dropping to $1 that okay. much no more.
Okay.
So that's why the money is more, you know, on the owner side.
Okay.
So after the expense.
So if I am a dry van, let's say, so monthly, what should I be targeting at? Like how much of revenue first, forget the profits, how much of revenue should I be targeting if I'm a dry van in current market?
Like you are a driver or a
driver.
You are a driver. You're driving. Driver.
Yeah. I'm driving. Yeah, like driver. Yes.
Yeah, like driver. You can target the same. You know, like 5,000 a week. You need to be your target. You know, between 4,000 and 5,000 a week. You know,
20,000 per month revenue is a good number.
Yeah, it's a good number. Yeah,
and
that's how we target. Yeah.
And what about a reefer? If I'm a reefer. If I have a
reefer, he can be a little bit up, depends on the week. At the end of the year, they're gonna balance, but maybe like 10 to 20% more than regular dry vans, you know.
Okay.
Depends how you're running.
Correct. So possibly maybe between 23 and 25,000 a month.
Yeah, exactly. 20 to 25, maybe more. Yeah. You know, depends,
but the expense is
everything.
Cheaper, right? The expense
is
more expensive because of the, you know, the fuel that burns and it's comparatively, right? So you need to make more money on reefer.
Yeah, you need to make more money. You have repair on the reefer, you have maintenance. Yeah, you need to make more money. Yeah, for sure.
Okay.
Yeah.
What about flatbeds? Is it a good market for flatbeds?
Usually,
right,
I didn't run flatbeds on my company.
Mm-hmm.
Not at all, to tell you the truth. I didn't run flatbeds. I don't know how are the rates right now on the flatbeds.
Okay. Mm-hmm.
I have friends, they doing flatbeds, but I don't know exactly to tell
okay.
you. Know. Right now,
okay.
I'm doing just driving and reefer.
All right, and so you're saying, so we should be targeting between $20,000 to $25,000 a month, right? That's a good number if you have a single equipment and you are driving and you are the owner operator. And you know, how much? What are the typical expenses? Let's say there are certain expenses which are personal. I'm talking about the standard repetitive expenses that can be there, right? The insurance is there. What are those expenses? And
Insurance is always going to be there, you know. You know,
okay.
The insurance, you need to pay it, and then you have maintenance on the truck, oil
right.
changes,
mm-hmm.
you have repairs, tires,
right?
You know, a lot of stuff, they're going to come every year, you know. Annual inspection, you need to pay,
right?
So, reefer maintenance, so it's going to come, all those stuff, they're going to come, you know.
Yeah.
You need to, when it's a good market, it's good to have some money in the side every time for repairs, you know, to save it if you can, because it's going to help you in the long run, you know.
In the long run,
yeah.
Well, and so in the current market, what is the dollar per mile that you are seeing? How much can, you know, how much? Because I believe that you need to focus on dollar per mile, right, by booking the load. I think that's what you
yeah.
that time 4 years back. So I guess the same philosophy you will be following right now.
So, you know, when we're talking in the beginning, the rate of dollar a mile was like $2, like in the beginning. Right now, he kind of go up, you know, like $2.50, $3. If you shoot that rate, that's very good, you know. That's what you're looking right now, yeah, to make that money, yeah. That's why I'm saying the current market from last year and is getting better, you know. Last year was very crazy boom. You getting loads with $4 a mile, you know. So you want to average $3, you know. It was crazy last year, yeah. That's why the business is all they got very up, you know, the tracking, you know. So right now we're just maintaining that, you know. Try to shoot $2.50 to $3 easy, you know.
That's good, because I remember when we were dispatching, when I was in 2017, I believe, the rate was 1.8, 1.7.
Exactly.
It was a bloodshed, I remember, because it was so difficult to find something in the $2
range. The staff jet is going to go up and down. You're never going to know, you know, but right now the market is high, you know.
Okay.
It's high.
Is it because of Corona or it's because it's stabilizing now? The market is now stabilizing or should be like this?
Maybe, to tell you the truth, maybe because of Corona was some push, some something, maybe. Or maybe it was a part, I know they were claiming about the brokers, you know, to give more share to the carriers and stuff, you know. They were trying to do something last year. Mm-hmm. So all this stuff, maybe it's influencing to get more money a mile, you know. So,
Right.
So, I'm not sure exactly what's going on, but something is going on.
So, you know, you said good. You said the brokers. You know, I get a lot of truckers who hate brokers. Do you hate brokers?
No, I don't. No, I don't.
They're also doing the job, right? They're also doing the job. So, you know.
It's not. It's a business. You know, you don't need to take it personal. You know, if they want to make money, they have families. You want to make money, you have families. You know, that's why the way it is right now. It's not like before. That's why I said maybe the brokers or they push something in the government and they pay more. Okay. Because right now the way it's going, nobody's complaining. Not the driver, not exactly. You know. Everybody's happy because I think everybody's getting their shares. You know.
Okay.
So it's more evenly. You know. That's why, because before it was a little bit harder to have all the maintenance, all the stuff coming, and then to get $1.80, $2 a mile, it's very hard, you know, to maintain you know.
Okay.
Right now it's much easier, so,
So how much can I save, let's say, after, you know, in a good month, let's say, I do a 20 dry van, how much should I be saving as a profit? I'm not taking off the expenses which can come out, like tire change and all, regular after the fuel and after the insurance and lease. How much should I be targeting to earn as an owner operator, like per month I should be able to save per truck
if you are the drivers and everything, you want to put the money in the sides, you know, is between 5,000 and 10,000 you can put in the side, you know.
Okay.
Yeah, you can put. But if, let's say, it depends on the month or how it's going the market, let's say if you put 5,000 in your saving, you know, after everything, all the expensive or whatever you try to do with your money, then it's I think it's good, you know.
Yeah, so anything above 5,000 is a good number. Like, I should be like,
yeah.
Because I remember I spoke to a lot of owner operators early, and when we were doing a bit of their payrolls, bookkeeping. So what I was saying is, it was an average of 6,000 to 8,000 is what, you know, you were trying to save if you were an owner operator per month after all the expenses, like as your profit. So how much do drivers make? So if I was driving and I'm not owning this, like just a driver, roughly how much can I make if I'm doing long hauls?
With the driver, they're limited usually, like everybody, by the miles, you know. So if they drive like 3,000 miles, 35, you know, like in regulation and stuff, you're going to be end up, now they're paying like 65 a mile, you know. Like
I see.
So, from when I started, it was 35. So think about it. Now it's 65.
Obviously, 10 years have passed. So,
exactly. So it's a big difference, you know. So a lot of people, they're looking for drivers. It's very hard to find right now drivers, you know. But think about it. If they do like 3,000 by 6, how much is making a week, you know?
$1,800 per week.
They make it easy 2,000 a week, easy 2,000 to 3,000. So that is their money, you know, because they don't have too many expensive, you know. So like a driver, you can put it like 25, 3,000 a week, yeah.
Yeah, so let's say if I'm making 2,000, so in a month I should be, you know, if as a driver I should be making how much, like $6,000-$7,000?
Yeah, 6-7, roughly. I think between 8 and 10,000, to tell the truth. They don't make less than 2,000 right now, you know.
Yeah, 8,000.
If you drive 3,000 miles, it's like 65, it's almost 2,000, you know.
Yeah.
It's 18, 19. So he's making like 2,000 easy, you know.
Yeah, okay.
He's making 1,000 easy, yeah.
So now,
so 8,000 is the average, yeah.
Okay, so now as a driver, I'm making 8,000 per month. Now, as an owner-operator, you are saying that I should, so as an owner-operator, I should be making more, right? Correct?
Yeah. You should get more. Yeah.
So I should be making more than 8,000, right? So when we say that he should be saving 5,000 or 6,000, you're saying is after everything, after taking his salary.
Yeah.
Okay. So you're saying, so primarily as an owner operator, I should be making anything about 10,000, 13,000. So another 3-4,000 extra dollars, because I'm taking off the salary of a driver myself. Correct?
Exactly. If you pay, let's say if you make 10,000 and you pay a driver like 8 to 10,000, depends how you pay him, you know.
Right.
You end up with 10,000. So usually that's how it was before. The driver and the owner were doing 50-50, you know.
Correct.
The only thing are those 10,000, let's say the owner is getting, he needs to pay repair if he has that month, or you understand?
Correct.
If he doesn't have it, then it's a save for him, you know. He's doing kind of the same with the owner, yeah.
Correct. So, to summarize, as an owner operator, I should be targeting anything, if I have a dry van, reefer, right? And even a flatbed, I remember, because they also make between 18 to 25,000 roughly. So
yeah.
I should be looking at anything, an average of $20,000 per month. And if I am driving, so after cutting off the basic expenses of fuel, insurance, everything, I should be at least be saving anything about 10 to 12,000 per month, right? In that 4-5,000, I should be able to save apart from my salaries, correct?
Yeah, you're supposed to save, yeah. If you don't have repair
costs, yeah. I keep 8,000 for my effort of drive as a driver, and then I earn another 4 or 5,000 over that because I'm an owner operator. So roughly 10 to 12,000 per month, I should be able to save 8,000 as an expense. Roughly 6 to 8,000 as an expense monthly it goes for fuels and everything.
Yes. Yeah, in the current market, yeah, kind of like that. Yeah.
Okay. So what you're saying is, right now the market is really good. The rates are really good as compared to what it was 2-3 years back. And do you predict it to be the same like this?
No, I was predicted to be like January, roughly February, but it was a drop. It was a drop a little bit, like end of January. Beginning of February, you know.
Okay.
And then he catch up, he kind of even up. So right now we still don't know what is the deal, you know. Right now the market is good, you know. If he's staying like that, he doesn't need to go up and down. He's very good, you know. But we'll see. Yeah, we'll see. Because it's still March, April before the produce is starting, the reefer are moving, you know. The summer is coming. Mm-hmm. So we'll see what's gonna happen. Yeah, because usually these months are kind of low, you know. After January, February, March is very low.
So
but no complaint.
So I guess what we're trying to say here is, guys, if you're trying to become an owner operator, you are there to make money. So if you want to make money, you need to make anything around, save at least 12,000 a month, right? Then you're good to be, right? Because if you're not able to do that, if you're not able to find the right loads, if you're not able to save that much of money, I mean, you will get hurt in the long run. Right?
Exactly. You get
that. That's the reason. We all are here to make money. That's the reason you're starting your business. So you need to do the business in the right way so that you can save money and you can make lots of money and you can grow your business. Right? Cool.
Exactly.
Good. That was really good, Connell. I just wanted to discuss, because this is one of the most common things that we hear. How much does a trucker make monthly? Because there are a lot of things, you know, and it, as you said, it also depends on the market. Right now the market is good. We don't know how the market might be after 6 months. As I said, 4 years back, it was just half of this, almost close to 60% rates of what.
Because these rates, they kind of double up, to tell you the truth, you know. It's kind of double up. Yeah. Before, when I started, the owner operator was doing max like 10,000, you know, maybe 12, you know, after all the expensive, you know, like owner operator. So if you were getting a repair for 5,000 or something in that month, it was cutting into your profit and stuff, you know.
Yeah.
So right now it's a little bit in the high side, you know. So but I hope it's gonna stay like this.
Let's hope everything goes well. You know, you guys work really hard. All the drivers work hard. Owner operators work hard. It's a very The whole, even the last year, the whole industry, it's because of the trucking industry, the whole economy sustained. Everyone was at home, you know, everything that was moved around and, you know, all the facilities that...
Yeah, thanks God. Yeah, thanks God the trucking was the story. Yes, it was,
it was the trucking was, that, you know,
was running. Yeah, I didn't complain last year about that.
Yes, yes.
They were moving, you know.
Good. So, Connell, this is what I wanted to discuss. You know, we will have another video, you know, with you, you know, because you are a close friend. So, you know, thanks for coming on the channel and sharing your insights with us. It's good to have you, Connell. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much, Jerry. I appreciate it and see you next time.
That was Cornell from Comic Logistics. To summarize the interview, it is a good time to be in trucking business, frankly, because of two reasons. The loads are paying much better and the rates are more consistent as compared to how it was 2 years back. So if you're an owner-operator with a dry land deep or flatbed, you should be aiming at making a revenue of between $20,000 to $30,000 a month. And you should be saving 60% of that in your pockets. Now, if, you know, you got into this business primarily because you wanted to do something of your own self, but also to make money. So go make money. Please like the video, subscribe to our channel to stay updated. Till next time, drive safe. May God bless you and your business abundantly. Bye.